myself first, and then we'll go ahead with this discussion further. My name is Preeti Dubey. I'm a management psychologist, and I help organizations in developing culture, the right culture conducive for their growth, and I also work with them on their leadership development projects. I would begin with you. Pavan, could you please introduce yourself?
Hi, good morning everyone. My name is Pavan Desai. I'm the co-founder and CEO of a company called MitKat Advisory. MitKat stands for Mitigating Knowledge Age Threats. It's headquartered in Mumbai, but we service clients across Asia Pacific. We have a setup in Singapore also. As the name suggests, we help a lot of corporates, multinational companies, and government agencies to mitigate varied kinds of threats, right? Emanating which can hamper their businesses. It ranges from geopolitical risk to physical security risk to business resiliency to cybersecurity. That essentially what we help them, advise them, and help them implement to improve their top line as well as improve their bottom lines. And we have been in business for almost close to a decade now. And I think this is my first time in Horasis, though my partners have been in Horasis since inception. I think it has been a fantastic couple of years, knowing people, meeting with them, coming from diverse countries, diverse geographies, diverse backgrounds, and it has been a phenomenal and really engrossing 2 days of our interactions.
Absolutely. How about you, Shibu?
Yeah. So, like Preeti mentioned, it's my second year at Horasis. It's always nice to come back to Horasis, to the city of Binh. Maybe if Horasis was not there, I wouldn't be coming to Binh. I don't know. It's not on the really on the map of places where you would really go. But because of Horasis, a city like Binh gets noticed. I think the World Trade Center came up last year, and I think going forward, I think communities which come across in Horasis, those are the people that will drive innovation and usage of things like the World Trade Center. Coming to what I do and what my business is, I run offshore developmental centers. Basically, we run IT companies in India. We have clients across North America right now. I also run a co-working space called Hat Spaces. I also work with the government of Kerala, which is a state in India. I work with them on aerospace and defense. So in that role, I work with startups and innovation and disruptive technologies. So it's nice that a place like Binh Duong in Vietnam is trying to nurture innovation, trying to bring across various businesses to the place, give a platform for wonderful discussions, great platform to meet people like Vicky and Pavan, who are from diverse businesses, get to learn so much from all the people out here. So it's a wonderful learning process, and at the same time, I think the city benefits tremendously. The local population benefits tremendously because they also get to hear and understand what business requirements are. So I think overall, Horasis does a wonderful job actually in bringing people like us to such a distant place and putting us through so many thought-provoking discussions, which are all extremely helpful.
And the good thing is, this is one platform where, in a very professional yet casual way, we are able to talk about what we do and how do we think about the issues that impact, global economy and things like gender gap, things like what happens, longevity, things about how to make youth become, take more initiatives, critical thinking. Those are diverse topics that we talk about. All three of us, I think one thing that kind of binds us together is all three of us are inclined towards skills development. And we see that as the change is now becoming a constant, a larger constant now. And because change is happening so fast, the only way to keep up with it is to we will do a complete learning and intervention, especially from behavioral aspects, and we focus on emotional intelligence, because emotional intelligence is can be developed in focus areas, and that is how we help the leaders and the teams work together. I interacted with Mohan, I interacted with Shibu, and we've spoken about women especially. We also spoke with Frank, and he said that he wants to have around at least 50 women involved in Horasis. I think all three of us align in that vision. I work very closely with women leaders, worked with women leaders to identify what holds them back. We've had meeting was the topic that I was given, which I chaired, was gender gap. Prior to that, I had done workshops on with women leaders. But on that platform, we got to speak, we had such open and candid conversations with leaders from different backgrounds. And we discussed how we can help them break the glass ceiling. And I'm very passionate about this, but was very happy to see closing gender gap is one thing that we need to partner with men, because a lot of men are in those senior positions and they're playing diverse roles where they can help, and together men and we need to work together to work towards that. Pawan, in security space, I think you do a fantastic job in helping women become more proactive in taking care of themselves. Would you just
in the last almost 3 to 4 years, we have been working on the theme of women empowerment.
Okay.
As a part of that, I think we have now trained upward of 100,000 women employees in India and neighboring countries, and we have done almost more than 3,000 training sessions across various corporates, almost hundreds of them. Basically, what we feel is women empowerment is one of the topic which gets spoken about at various forums. But the underlying part is the first level. If you say the in the hierarchy level, the lowest level is the security. They have to first feel secure to be on the top table or to do anything which is outside that comfort zone. The first important aspect is the security aspect of that. So because we come from the risk management space, we focus more on women empowerment from the security aspect. So we have trained, as I said, upward of 100,000 women employees on security aspect. So security should not become an hindrance. So that should not become a growth impediment. So once they, and it is more about awareness and psychological barrier rather than becoming experts on martial arts. So it is more about the conditioning, what we are used to. And we, when we say we, female as well as males, both. And especially in countries like India, I think training both the sides is very, very important. So I think we have been able to do that very successfully in the last 3 or 4 years, and numbers speaks for itself. And that program is really appreciated by various fraternities, various agencies, and that has given us a really good, I think, a cause to do more and better in that space. And we are fully committed for that, that mission, on empowering women.
That's a remarkable job. I think one of the major hindrances that women feel is about their own security. And once, if you're sure that you don't feel threatened by people around you, or and we all hear about cases that happen, which women have to kind of deal with. If they are sure that they've learned, and like you rightly said, it's more about psychological aspects. Being sure that yes, if a situation arises, I can take care of myself. Even if I'm going to a territory which I'm alien to, but still, because I know that at least physically I can manage myself and there's no threat to me, I would be more confident in going to those spaces. So I think that's a fantastic job that you do. Coming to you, Shibu, STEM is one industry. We know that there's so much growth happening in that space. And gender gap, according to World Economic Forum, will take 108 years to kind of fill in to close the gender gap. And to achieve parity in terms of employment between men and women, it'll take over 200 years. Now that's a huge gap. And considering that if women start, you know, if we are able to close the gap, get more women to work, in the next 25 years, almost 25 trillion will go to the global economy. So women are a huge trend. They can contribute a lot. But we all know that in STEM, a lot of women are lacking for various reasons. Some women do not have the privilege to actually access technology or to benefit from the growth that's happening in that field. And some women probably have this natural, way of thinking that STEM is not for me. And today in my panel, one of the ladies, a Japanese lady, she said when she was growing up, during her growing up years, she was very passionate about technology. But because it was not something that was very well accepted within the society, she was strongly discouraged to pursue her interest in technology. So those kind of challenges arise, and considering now the pace of growth is going to be in STEM more than in any other field, and if women are kind of lagging behind in those areas, then the gender gap, instead of closing, probably it will become, it will take a lot more time to close. So you spoke recently about, that you're working something in that direction. Would you like to enlighten us?
I think one of the fundamental things is that, 50% of the human population is the ladies. So going forward, we have to be extremely cautious that everybody has to be happy in this world, and women especially, I think they have a lot of intrinsic power. I especially witnessed it when I saw, when my child was born, I saw the real power of a lady when, she goes through the pain. So women have a very high EQ. That's something which I really strongly believe. So, these things like STEM also, I think if you give the right kind of opportunities to ladies, they really blossom. So what we did last time in the Horasis Summit, I met with one of the panelists here, Virginia Tan. So she runs a program called She Loves Tech. So we launched She Loves Tech across India from where we are. So we ran an initial program in India, and we did select some of the women startups. So we were quite amazed with the things that actually women did, in spite of the limitations or the so-called requirements of family. Even if you try to free a woman, I think a woman would always love her child and, those kind of things. So the domestic responsibilities that a woman puts upon herself, in spite of what the society demands, those kind of pressures on a woman actually restrict her time and bandwidth. But in spite of that, we are amazed at some of the ideas that the women entrepreneurs came up with. And surprisingly, some of them took it forward. Maybe give a small example, if a tech solution need not be, somebody who's working
on AI. Ladies and gentlemen, the green room is commencing shortly. Please proceed to the auditorium at 402. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the plenary is commencing shortly. Please proceed to the auditorium at 402. Thank you.
Kính thưa quý vị, phiên họp toàn thể sẽ diễn ra trong ít phút nữa. Mời quý vị di chuyển đến hội trường chính tại tầng 2. Xin cảm ơn. Kính thưa quý vị,